He said, "In my yard, I have the best mango tree in Port of Spain, and now the mangoes are ripe and red and are very sweet and juicy. I have waited here for you to tell you this and to invite you to come and eat some of my mangoes." So the poet further on says that, "I was waiting for you to tell that I am having the best mango tree in Port of Spain at my place, and now as the mangoes are ready to be eaten, they are very sweet and juicy, so I want you to come to my place and have some mangoes." He lived in Alberto Street in a one-roomed hut placed right in the center of the lot. The yard seemed all green. There was a big mango tree, there was a coconut tree, and there was a plum tree. The place looked wild, as though it wasn't in the city at all. You couldn't see all the big concrete houses in the street. So that man lived in Alberto Street and in a single-room hut which was right in the center of the lot. The yard at his place was all green, it was all natural. There was a big mango tree plus a coconut tree and a plum tree. The entire yard was all full of greenery, it was all natural. The place was looking wild. Wild means it was in a natural state, nothing artificial was found there, and it seemed that the place was in the outskirts, it was not in the city, as one couldn't see a big concrete houses in that street. Big concrete houses means houses that are made up of cement and brick. There were only normal houses. He was right, the mangoes were sweet and juicy. I ate about 6, and the yellow mango juice ran down my arms to my elbows and down my mouth to my chin, and my shirt was stained. So the boy visited his place, which was in Alberto Street, and he had some mangoes. Then he says that the man was right, the mangoes were really sweet and juicy. He ate around six mangoes, and while he was eating the mangoes, the mango juice ran down from his arms to his elbows and from his mouth to his chin, and in that way his shirt was also stained. That is, his shirt had the patches of mango juice. My mother said, "When I got home, where you was? You think you is a man now and could go all over the place? Go cut a whip for me." She beat me rather badly, and I ran out of the house swearing that I would never come back. I went to B. Wordsworth house. I was so angry, my nose was bleeding. So when he returned back home, he got quite late. So his mother was very angry, and she asked him that, "Where you were roaming? You think you are a man now and you can go anywhere without telling me? Go cut a whip for me." Whip stands for, whip means a piece of rope. She wanted a whip so that she could beat him, and she did beat the boy very badly. And after, she used the whip for beating him, the boy got angry and he ran out of the house, and he told his mother that, "I will never return back to this place as you have beaten me so badly." So after he left his place, he straightaway went to B. Wordsworth's house, and he was very angry. His nose was bleeding. The blood was coming out from his nose. B. Wordsworth said, "Stop crying and we will go for a walk." I stopped crying, but I was breathing short. We went for a walk. We walked down St. Clair Avenue to the Savannah, and we walked to the race course. So when B. Wordsworth saw the boy that he was bleeding, he was crying, he asks the boy that, "Please don't cry, and if you stop crying, we will go for a walk." So the boy liked the idea of going for a walk. He stopped crying, but still he was breathing short. Then they both went for a walk. They walked down St. Clair Avenue to the Savannah, and they also walked to the race course. B. Wordsworth said, "Now let us lie on the grass and look up at the sky, and I want you to think how far those stars are from us." After he was in a better situation, B. Wordsworth said that, "Now we will lie on the grass and we will start staring at the stars, which are quite far from us, and I want you to think the distance between us and the stars." I did as he told me, and I saw that what he meant. I felt like nothing, and at the same time, I had never felt so big and great in all my life. I forgot all my anger and all my tears and all the blows. When I said I was better, he began telling me the names of the stars, and I particularly remembered the constellation of Orion, the Hunter, though I don't really know why. I can spot Orion even today, but I have forgotten the rest. So, the man asked the boy to lie down on the grass and see the stars. He did the same, and he felt like nothing, but at the same time, he was really feeling good because he has never done such activity earlier in his entire life. So, he was very happy. He forgot all his anger and his tears, and everything vanished away. Then the boy said that I am feeling better now. So the poet started telling him the name of the stars, and the boy especially remembered the constellation of Orion, the Hunter. Constellation means a group of stars. He was able to identify Orion even today, but regarding the rest, he was not remembering the name of rest of the stars. Then a light was flashed in our faces and we saw a policeman. We got up from the grass. The policeman said, "What are you doing here?" B. Wordsworth said, "I've been asking myself the same question for 40 years. Then, as they were watching the stars lying on the grass, a policeman came and he flashed the light of his torch on their faces. So, when the light flashed on their faces, they got up and the policeman asked the B. Wordsworth that, "What are you doing here?" B. Wordsworth replied in a very funny way that this question I am myself asking to me for last 40 years, but till now I have not got the answer. So how can I tell you that what I am doing here? We became friends, B. Wordsworth and I. He told me, "You must never tell anybody about me and about the mango tree and the coconut tree and the plum tree. You must keep that a secret. If you tell anybody, I'll know because I am a poet." I gave him my word and I kept it. So later on, they both became friends. They started talking about life and different topics. So one day, B. Wordsworth told him that, "You must never tell anyone regarding me, regarding my mango tree, regarding my place, regarding the natural scenery there. It must be a secret between you and me. And if you will tell it to anybody, I'll surely get to know because I am a poet and poet knows everything." So the boy promised him that he won't tell anything about him to anyone, and he kept his promise also.